Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16 has hundreds and hundreds of features and changes. And within those, some are more obvious, such as the lock screen with customizable widgets, but there's a lot of little small changes that make life more convenient. So I thought we'd go over the most helpful iOS 16 features. Some of them you may already have heard of if you've been following along with iOS 16, and some of them hopefully you haven't and are new to you. Now, the first one has to do with settings and under Wi-Fi. So if we tap on Wi-Fi and we have our Wi-Fi network here, if we tap on the eye, we can now see our password or copy and paste it to someone. So maybe we have a friend or family member over and we need to give them our Wi-Fi password, but they don't have an iPhone where you can just bring it up close. You can tap on your password. It will verify via Face ID or Touch ID. Then you can tell them your password, or you can copy and paste it maybe to an SMS or text message and share it that way. So it's made it really much easier and more convenient in iOS 16. With previous versions of iOS, we gained live text. Live text is a super convenient and useful feature within the camera, or that it recognizes within photos. But what you can do now, instead of just copy and paste text, it can do much more. So as long as your device supported it before, you can use these features. So if we slide in maybe the Chinese version of apple.com, you'll see it recognizes it as live text, this little button here. And when you see this, you can tap on translate. Now you can do this with anything, whether that be maybe a pamphlet that's on the side of a building, you're trying to understand what it says, maybe you're traveling, you can now translate it in real time. And it also adds the addition of Japanese, Korean, and Ukrainian text. So they continue to update this. It is not available everywhere, unfortunately, but as if it was available before with live text, it will be available now with those additional regions. Also, you can do more with this as well. So if we go to another website where we have maybe currency here. So again, it recognizes live text in real time. Tap on it here, and you'll see that we can now recognize that it's British pounds. Tap on it, and we can convert it instantly to US dollars, to whatever your local currency is. So this works across many different things, not just text now. It recognizes things such as the weather. So maybe you're in a country you want to convert something to Celsius. Again, here's the weather. It recognizes live text, and then we can convert it to Celsius, Fahrenheit, or even it recognizes it as an angle or degree. So if we want to convert this to Celsius, it tells us Kelvin, Fahrenheit, and Celsius. So that's a really nice, easy conversion that it will do, and it gets better over time. And live text not only works with photos and your camera, but also works within videos as well. So maybe you're watching a video, and in the middle of that video, you pause it, you see something that you recognize. You'll see here the live text button. It recognizes different elements within the text. In this case, it's recognizing the temperature. Tap on the temperature and you can convert it again to Fahrenheit or convert the angle. So live text works within video also, not just photos and with your camera. Again, it's recognizing the word iPhone there, and you'll see all of the things it sees within the frame. So it's really great to have those new options built in, making things more and more convenient, and you don't need an additional app to do it. Something else that will be more and more helpful as time goes on has to do with passwords or passkeys. Apple introduced passkeys, and this is a new way to sign into websites using Face ID and helps protect against phishing and website leaks. Many of us have experienced that. And here's an example website. So if we go to sign in, it will actually pop up a little dialogue here saying, choose how you'd like to sign in. iPhone, iPad, or Android device. You can use a passkey from a device with a camera or a security key, and then you can also share this. So if we continue, you can scan this with a QR code reader and sign in with passkey. It makes it super convenient. You won't need to use passwords anymore and will be widely supported as Apple has partnered with the FIDO Alliance to sort of have this as a standard across Google and Microsoft as well and other larger password managing companies. So this is something you're going to see more and more that just makes signing in more convenient and also much more secure. So hopefully we have it sooner rather than later. At the time of this video, it's very few and far between, but this is a demo, and if you want to try it out, I'll link it in the description. The next thing has to do with accessibility features. If you have a phone that has a LiDAR sensor, this is really, really convenient and helpful if you need accessibility features. So for those that are visually impaired, if we go into the Magnifier app, so you can use Magnifier, and I've put it here on the second page. The Magnifier app has a new feature in it that allows you to detect doors. So it's got a detection mode. It activates the LiDAR on the back and also recognizes objects. And as you can see here, it's recognizing doors, telling me how close or how far I am from them, what they are, whether there's text there, and everything else. So this is really nice. It gives audible indications as to what's going on and can read what's on the screen. So it has image descriptions. You can see it can detect people, which we had before, but now it can detect doors as well. So that's something that's super helpful for those that need it. And it works really well. I think it will get better over time. But again, if you need those features, they're super helpful for those that are visually impaired. The next helpful feature is in Mail. Within Mail, they've added some features. Some of them you'll see all of the time, some of them you won't. One of them is follow-up. If you've sent a message and maybe no one's responded in a certain amount of time, Apple will actually pop a little dialogue in the top reminding you to follow up with them if maybe you need to do that. If we go to send an email, so we'll reply to this one, we'll just reply to this one, and you'll see some of the light mode versus dark mode isn't showing properly. But if we press and hold on the send button, we have some new options. So we can send now, send tonight, send tomorrow, or send later based on our schedule. So this is a really convenient, helpful feature that they've added in Mail. Now within your main mailbox, if you want to be reminded about something later, you can now do that. Swipe your mail to the right slightly and you have Remind Me. If you tap on Remind Me, you can have it remind you in an hour, tonight, tomorrow, or later, similar to sending later as well. Also, you can undo send. So maybe you just sent an email. In your settings, you can change the duration of how long you have to wait. But if you go into Mail, scroll to the bottom, you have an undo send delay. So it will actually delay sending it for up to 30 seconds, although you could set it to 10 or 20. And then maybe you made a mistake, you want to undo send, you can do that. However, you can't do this for up to 15 minutes or 30 minutes later currently. So those are all new features built into Mail that I think make it even more useful and helpful compared to other mail apps out there, but it also keeps everything private and secure. Now, to go along with privacy and security, if we go into settings, go down to the privacy and security section, scroll down to the bottom, we have some new options. Safety check is the first helpful update. It says if circumstances or trust levels change, safety check allows you to disconnect from people, apps, and devices you no longer want to be connected to. You can do an emergency reset or manage sharing and access. So you can customize which people and apps can access your information and review your security account. So that's something that's really great that they've added. And then even more so is lockdown mode. Lockdown mode under the same settings of privacy and security has the option to completely lock down your phone if you think your phone's at risk of data breach. So it says lockdown mode is an extreme optional protection that should only be used if you believe you may be personally targeted by a highly sophisticated cyber attack. Most people are never targeted by attacks of this nature. When iPhone is in lockdown mode, it will not function as it typically does. Apps, websites, and features will be strictly limited for security, and some experiences will be completely unavailable. So if you're a little bit concerned about this, you can turn this on and learn more about what it does. But it's really nice that they've added this if you're very concerned or might be targeted by a cyber attack. Photos gained some very helpful options in iOS 16. The first one is a shared photo library. So if we go into settings, go to our name at the top, under iCloud, tap on Photos. Under Photos, we can actually share this with someone else under Shared Library. This allows us to share it with up to 5 people where we can share the library together, maybe with a family or a loved one or someone else, maybe a good friend. And then you can selectively select which photos you want to share. You can have them all share or just based on which ones you're taking in your photo or your camera app. So that's something that's really convenient. And even better in Photos is they now have an option for duplicates. It will find duplicates and you can merge them on its own. This is something that's been really helpful on Mac with different apps for a long time and has now been brought to iOS. Also, you have hidden and recently deleted that now allows you to lock them. So those are convenience features that small touches that I think are really helpful. So if you have a hidden folder, it's now locked by Face ID. The same is true with recently deleted. If you have some private images you wanted to get rid of, they'll go into recently deleted and then they'll delete after 30 days if you don't manually delete them. So that's really nice that they've added those helpful features. Another really helpful feature is Apple has finally given AirPods their own menu. If we go into settings, you'll see there's nothing there, but if we connect AirPods Pro, AirPods Max, or any AirPods, you'll see it immediately shows a new menu. Under that menu, we have different options for noise cancellation, transparency, different things such as the ear tip fit test on the Pros, personalized spatial audio. So it will depend on which AirPods you have as to what options you have, but they've given it its own menu, which makes things much more helpful as far as that goes. Before, it was buried in Bluetooth settings or in accessibility. Now it's just its own menu, and hopefully they'll give us an update button as well as new updates are available. One feature that can be really helpful, but is specific to iPhone 13 for some reason, is the ability to unlock your iPhone in landscape mode. Now, you can't typically use your phone in landscape mode unless you're watching a video or maybe looking at photos, where you could before and had a whole landscape layout on iPhone 8 Plus, but you can unlock it only on the iPhone 13 models though. So if we rotate it to landscape, it will unlock. You see the lock unlocked. I'll do it one more time. You'll see it unlocks in landscape, just like our iPad does that has Face ID, the iPads Pro. So I'm not sure why it's not on older iPhones. Maybe the Face ID hardware is slightly different or the Neural Engine can't do it, but either way, it's on the iPhone 13 models. One of the most helpful features for me that I've found that I've used an awful lot with iOS 16 has to do with messages. So if we go into messages, we now have the ability to edit a message after we've sent it. So we can edit it. It will give us sort of a change log as to what we've edited, but up to 15 minutes later, we can edit the message or we can undo send for up to 2 minutes. So if we press and hold on a message we've already sent, we have the option to undo send. However, if it's an older message, we cannot undo send or edit it. It just depends on how long it's been since you've sent it. So here is a message. We'll type this, hit send. Then if I press and hold, I can edit that message and say, maybe I want to say this is a new message, just for an example here. Now we've typed it and it sends and then edits it. It gives us a change log as to what we've changed before, just so we have some accountability. And then we can see what it says. Now, also the person on the other side has this change log as well. And if they don't have iMessage, it will actually, or even iOS 16, it will actually just send them two messages and say that it was edited. So that's something that's a little bit new that I think is really helpful and convenient. Of course, also built into this is voice dictation, and you can now edit your voice dictation while you're speaking. So voice dictation this time around is incredibly helpful. And if I need to stop, I can just press the button here and it will continue to speak or type as I speak. And then if I want to edit it, I want to edit, you can type and then it will continue as you speak. So this is really helpful as you're typing using dictation. It's gotten better. It adds punctuation and has been enhanced. So that's something that's really good if your phone supports it. And so hopefully those are some very helpful features that maybe some of them you didn't know about. And if you didn't know about them, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. There are many, many more, but I couldn't cover them all. It would probably take me over an hour to cover every single convenience feature in here. But let me know what your favorite feature is as far as the most helpful feature goes and what you've found you've used most if you've been using iOS 16. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, it'll be linked in the description as it always is. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.